The title of this video might seem like an absurd claim, but it is completely true. I am not referring to the 19th century Great Famine or Potato Famine, or these other famines that have been called Great Famines that also occurred in Europe. Instead, we have to go way back to the early portion of the 14th century. From 1315 to 1317, a great famine would occur that affected almost the entirety of Europe, resulting in 8 million deaths, or about 10% of the continent's entire population. Effects were even worse for livestock, with as much as 80% fatality rates there. And this was largely due to New Zealand. I can see you raising your hand back there with a confused look saying, but wait, Europeans didn't even know of New Zealand, let alone arrive on it until more than 300 years later in 1642. During the 1300s, only native Maori lived in New Zealand, having first arrived in the 1250s, and there is no way they caused a famine a hemisphere away in Europe. And you'd be correct. That is why the title of this video is New Zealand Causing Europe's Great Famine Rather Than New Zealanders. The culprit was completely unrelated to humans or human activity, and instead was a natural cataclysm. Specifically, a volcano that many people on New Zealand's North Island have already seen or at least are aware of after it produced the nation's deadliest volcanic eruption in 1886. What I'm referring to is the Okataina Volcano, specifically its Tarawera complex, which produced a far more powerful and deadly volcanic eruption in 1314. This eruption left behind these three massive rhyolite lava domes that now mark the overall volcano's highest point. In total, 16.31 cubic kilometers of rhyolitic tephra was ejected across several days, meaning the eruption had a volcanic explosivity index of a 6, and the tallest the relevant eruption column reached was 28 kilometers or 92,000 feet. So, how did this far away volcanic eruption lead to so much hardship in Europe? The answer? An unusually strong volcanic winter. While many people think that the decline in temperatures implied by the name is the main danger during volcanic winters, this is not the case. And while yes, that can mess with typical weather patterns, generally speaking such declines are only a few degrees Celsius at most, and this trend tends to reverse with only a few years' time. Instead, the main problem is why exactly the drop in temperatures occurs during a volcanic winter. Such a drop in temperatures occurs due to a notable decline in the amount of sunlight reaching the surface, which itself occurs due to tall eruption plumes injecting unusually large amounts of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere. The sulfur dioxide then reacts to form sulfuric acid, and large amounts of this can block a substantial amount of sunlight. For example, an unusually sulfur dioxide-rich, low NVEI-5 explosive eruption from Mexico's El Chichon volcano in 1982 injected an estimated 7.5 million metric tons of sulfur dioxide, leading to up to 13.42% of all sunlight being blocked for a time. During exceptionally large explosive volcanic eruptions, this can temporarily reduce the amount of sunlight hitting the ground by as much as 67% for a time. This causes lower crop yields, if not outright crop failures, both of which happened between 1315 and 1317. However, while we do not have exact numbers on how much sulfur dioxide the VEI-6 explosive eruption of the Okataina volcano in 1314 emitted, a good estimate would be around 20 million metric tons. In other words, enough to cause a temporary 25% reduction in sunlight. This means that a hypothetical farmer growing crops near Paris, France in the Middle Ages would in essence have their growing season reduced by 53.3 days. Yet, what would have been a year of very low yield crops turned into outright disaster when weather patterns that typically carried moisture elsewhere shifted over the continent, causing a series of the wettest years on record, completely ruining crops. Due to the reduction in sunlight, ultraviolet radiation that killed bacteria, fungi, and viruses were reduced, meaning that these pests could spread at a higher rate among both plants and animals. And this is how New Zealand, specifically a volcanic eruption in New Zealand, was to blame for one of Europe's worst all-time famines. It serves as a warning that in certain parts of the world, food supplies may be vulnerable to the effects of future volcanic winters. Other volcanic winters that have also caused deadly famines occurred in 536, 1601 to 1603, and 1816. As a final note, I'd like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Mary Jones, for supporting my work.